So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the next session over design of retaining wall. So before going to today's discussion, I'll just brief out the discussion what I did discuss in the previous session. I'll just recall what I had discussed in the previous session. So we had the discussion over what is a retaining wall and what about its how it resists the lateral pressure and its pressure distribution. Then we had a discussion over the different types of retaining wall. After that we had a discussion over the different types of retaining wall here. So we discuss about what is a gravity retaining wall, what is a cantilever retaining wall, and what is a contrafort retaining wall. Okay, so that is gravity, cantilever retaining wall, and contrafort retaining wall. And as I told you, as per the syllabus, we have to design cantilever retaining wall and contrafort retaining wall. And after that, I discuss about the design forces and or the governing forces we need to consider for construction or the design of retaining wall. What are the forces we need to consider? So I told you there are basically the wall will be designed to resist the earth pressure, that is lateral earth pressure. So in that we have two, that is active earth pressure and passive earth pressure. Okay, as I told you, the wall retain the soil which is called as active earth pressure, and the other side the soil will be there that will develop the passive earth pressure. Okay, so we had the discussion also over that. Then the active earth pressure, so what is that active earth pressure? The wall moves away from the backfill, then it is called as active earth pressure. Okay, the wall moves away from the soil, then it is called as active earth pressure. And there are different cases, so you can see this pressure distribution is nothing but the active earth pressure. Okay, this pressure try to push the wall away from the backfill, so that's what is called as active earth pressure. And we have the different cases of active earth pressure just for the discussion, that is dry backfill with no surcharge, submerged backfill, then backfill with surcharge. And we had a discussion over that is what is a dry backfill with no surcharge, and we had discussed. So the first condition we discussed in the last session, that is dry backfill with no surcharge. So let us, if we have considered one, the vertical wall or the retaining wall with backfill, and the density of its gamma and height h. So this will develop the pressure distribution triangular in shape. So the pressure at base, the active earth pressure at the base will be, it will be like k into gamma into h. So this will be k into gamma into h, the pressure at the base of the retaining wall. At the base of the retaining wall here, at the base it is k into gamma into h. Okay, then what is ka? Ka is nothing but coefficient of active earth pressure, and gamma is the unit weight of backfill. And the ka is calculated based on, that is 1 minus sin phi up divided by 1 plus sin phi. What is phi here now? Phi is nothing but the angle of repose or angle of internal friction. That is 1 minus sin phi upon 1 plus sin phi. We can easily calculate ka here. Then the resultant of active earth pressure, so this is the total pressure developed at the base or on the face of the wall. So for that we have to find out its resultant. So the resultant of active earth pressure pa, so the resultant of this active earth pressure pa is per unit length of wall is calculated by, it is nothing but about half base height. So because it's a triangular in shape, so we have to consider its area, nothing but the resultant pressure or the force, we have to consider its area, half base, that is k into gamma into h, and height is h. So that is, we will get the resultant of active earth pressure for dry soil. This is very important. For dry soil it is PA is equal to K into gamma into S square by 2. And this will act at a distance h by 3 from the base of the retaining wall, because we know the centroid of the triangular shape, the centroid of the triangular shape, it will be at a distance h by 3 from the base. So this force PA, that is active work pressure, will act at a distance of h by 3 from the base of the retaining wall. Okay, then we will move on to next one more, that is the next next governing force, that is active work pressure, that is submerged backfill, that is with submerged backfill. Okay, so if it is submerged, okay, with submerged backfill, so I'll just, okay, so next one is submerged backfill. So if the backfill is submerged into the water, if the backfill is submerged into the water, okay, so we have, I'll just draw, we have the retaining wall here, so this is the retaining wall. Again for height h, again for height h, and we have the backfill here, we have the backfill. And with water, so this is water table, height of the water table. So this is our backfill with water. So if I want to draw the pressure distribution diagram for this, so what will happen here? So we will get the, again, first of all for soil. So it's a soil, so triangular in shape. So this will be K into gamma into H. Addition with that, we have water here. So water pressure will be also in triangular shape. So it will be addition of this. So this will be gamma W into H, correct na? So we have for water and we have for soil. Okay, so this total together it will be soil plus water, because it's a submerged na, so it will be soil plus water. So if I write here, therefore total lateral pressure so this is, I'll make it gamma dash. That is pressure due to submerged, this is very important, submerged weight of soil plus pressure due to water. That is pressure due to submerged weight of soil and pressure due to water. So when I write the statement, So therefore, PA will be equal to, that is due to the submerged weight of soil, what will happen here? K into gamma dash into H plus, because of water, gamma W into H. So where it is gamma dash is what? Gamma dash is the submerged weight, unit weight of soil, and gamma W is the unit weight of water. Correct. So this will be the final pressure, that is the active work pressure is K into gamma dash into H plus gamma W dash into H. Understood? Then if you have in this one more, this is the first one more. If free water surface stands, free water surface stands on both side of the wall. If you have free water surface on both side of the wall, okay. So here again, if you have the retaining wall, and you have the water both the side. Apart from that, we have backfill also. We have backfill. So when I draw the pressure distribution diagram, so we'll left with only this will be K into gamma dash into H. There will be, if I write, this will what will happen? Gamma W into H. So this will get nullified. This will get nullified because we have the water on both the side. So the pressure because of water from this side and the pressure because of water on from this side, both will get nullified. So we left it only what? K into gamma dash into H. So what will be here now? So therefore, the PA will be K into gamma dash into H. We left it only PA into gamma dash into H. If you have the free water surface strand both side of wall, both side of wall. So this will be the pressure distribution, and we have the ultimately the pressure is K into gamma dash into H, because the pressure due to water from the both side get nullified. Okay. Then we have after that backfill with surcharge. With surcharge means there will be some additional load over the retaining wall. So that time what will happen? Now we have to check that. So here the next condition is backfill with surcharge. So I'll draw the free body diagram here again. Free body diagram, and we have surcharge here, the additional weight over the soil. So this is surcharge acting its weight per meter, acting its weight per meter, and apart from that we have backfill also. This is backfill.
Correct.
And if I draw the pressure distribution diagram here, so we have the triangular shape that is for backfill, and we have one more that is for surcharge. So if I draw the, if I write the statement here, and this you can do the readjustment, and if I draw, if you do the readjustment in this, and if you draw, you will get the pressure will be, after the rearrangement, and if I draw it, so you'll get like this. Like this, and this is for the, so this is due to surcharge, and this is due to backfill. So what, this is the triangular portion, I took it front side, and this is I took it back side. So A kya hoga abhi, if I draw, if I write the total, so this will become as K into W, this is K into gamma into H. So this is K into W, W is for weight of surcharge, W stand for weight of surcharge, and K gamma into H, that is because of backfill, this is stand for backfill. And if I write the mathematical, in mathematical form, so therefore we have lateral pressure, lateral earth pressure will be like PA is K into gamma into H plus K into W, where W is because of surcharge. So what will happen if some material is stored here, or vehicle is there, truck is there, so what will happen, this surcharge will try to pressure this, and this soil will again oppositely try to pressure like this. So ultimately we got this pressure distribution diagram, that is due to surcharge and due to backfill. Understood? So these are some basic pressure distribution diagram with respect to the backfill material, or it may be with a dry soil, or it may be a submerged soil, or it may be with the dry soil with surcharge. Understood? Dry soil with surcharge. Okay, so these are the basic requirement for the prerequisite knowledge we should have before proceeding the design of retaining wall. So in the next session, we'll start with the design of retaining wall. So before that, you should have the prerequisite knowledge. So that is the reason I discussed about the types of retaining wall, what are the different types of pressures we need to consider, and again in that pressure with different conditions. Understood? So we'll meet it once again in the next session. So in the next session, I'll start with the design of retaining wall. Okay, and before that, if you have any queries, so you can let me know before proceeding the design of retaining wall. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.